There we are then, the clangers. Now, just before the clangers, Paula was saying that she she hated the ones with the hamsters and all that. And I thought I was getting it confused with a pornographic film, but what you actually meant was Hammy and a hamster and Nora Tells at a riverbank. And that was a disappointment to you when those came on?
Yeah, I hated those.
A strange child. I mean, I love that, the Hammy, hamster and all that, Tales at a riverbank, wooden tops. So I laugh.
Yeah, the wooden tops were all right. It was just Hammy I didn't like. What's on next?
Well, ZooTV. What do you know about
that? What a fine film it is.
Fine men.
Made by Kevin Godley, that well-known exponent of the video arts.
Yes, well-known exponent of the video arts. Featuring
Bono.
And U2.
And U2,
it's not Bono and U2, that's not the name of the
group. All right, it's U2.
The name of it is U2.
But featuring Bono, being vibrant and delicious and Irish and brooding and Celtic and...
The money hits the screen, it's super, isn't it?
What?
The money hits the screen.
Does it?
Very much so, yeah. Yeah. And I was thinking...
I've got something interesting, actually. He said to me the other day that he went... Bono, yeah. That he went for his tea at Frank Sinatra's house, and every room in Frank Sinatra's house is named after a different Frank Sinatra song, and the toilet's called My Way.
There you are. That is quite impressive.
Thank you.
That isn't... Yeah. I'm trying to think of something funny to say, but I can't. Maybe after this film, Oliver, because it'll give me sort of an hour and a half to think of something else. Well, keep watching. I hope you're awake.
Thank you for joining us live on the air.
My pleasure.
It was a place where everything was legal.
Television, the drug of a nation, bringing ignorance and feeding radiation on television. The drug of a nation, breeding ignorance and feeding radiation.
Report.
Its satellite links are United States of unconsciousness. Apathetic, therapeutic, and extremely addictive. The methadone metronome, pumping out 150 channels 24 hours a day. You can flip through all of them.
Television are convinced that the ability to portray immediacy, to realize what's new, what's going on, is the true significance of this new communication bridge.
The average family watches television over 7 hours a day. This is voluntary enslavement.
Yeah.
Hello, my friends. I mean you. You are here because you are interested in the unknown, the mysterious, the unexplainable.
Welcome to ZooTV. I'm David Salt, and we're down here in the underworld. This is the show, Believe the Show, and what happens down here is really amazing. It's where 327 tons of equipment wreck the ZooTV mammoth set. It comes off of 64 trucks with a crew of 500 guys that load it together, and we're going to show you around a little bit. Right up here on stage right, you can see where Edge's guitars emanate from. Dallas and there, off in Hands Edge, generally one of three guitars that he uses in the show tonight. Then the sequencing takes place here. The sound you're hearing right now at Zoo Station, that industrialized sound, gets sequenced right here from Dave. And we make our way back here. It's very expansive, yeah, very compact place. Right here is the electrical source. 42,000 kilowatts of power emanate out of these boxes. And no smoking down here, we'll tell you that.
The thugs and the third rate move into the seats of power.
The transforming power of technology is our pride and our neurosis.
I don't know what ZooTV is all about, so it must be ours.
Harry, fix the TV.
People are suffering from future shock. The future's arriving so fast that they're having difficulty coping with it.
It's no secret that the stars are falling from the sky. It's no secret that our world is in darkness tonight. They say the sun is sometimes eclipsed by a moon. You know I don't see you. She rocks at home. It's no secret that a friend is someone that's at home.
Secret that I am, I believe in no one else. This is a secret, it's something you tell one of the person, so I'll tell you.
TV, and the plane rips through the screens and right into the heart of the audience.
All of this sounds like science fiction or cyberpunk, but it's not. It's real.
Put your hand against the screen.
Good evening, I'm Rex Fox for Zoo News in New York. The category is athletics. Born in Czechoslovakia in 1901 with a free game card, the antibiotics arrived too late for thousands of satisfied motorists. An all-night vigil by protesters met with a year's free subscription. Call toll-free for ex-government salad sandwiches with a choice of fillings. Older ladies may prefer Beaver playing the decade of dance in a crisis currency debate. All these are stories
of the future.
Data of every description will pervade our consciousness. Holograms projected beneath our eyelids. Direct retinal stimulation.
Hey! New York! New York!
Zoo TV.
Let's go to Bono on stage.
So, let's watch some TV, shall we? You can never find the commercials when you need them.
Typical American television.
Yeah, I'm definitely going through my Fat Elvis period. Next! What's this, the Emmys or something?
Deborah Rogers. I think this must be...
Thank your mother and get it over with.
Yeah.
movies about rock and roll stars is they're bigger than life, they're bigger than the audience, they're almost intimidating. Well, this whole set is like that, right?
That's right, yeah.
Isn't that off-putting? Doesn't that kill intimacy, though?
It does, yeah, absolutely. But you look great.
I'm a working mother with two children successfully transplanted to a blind woman down 51 points to 9.59, a shameless crowd pleaser at low temperatures, narrowly escaped bankruptcy the size of the ozone hole. Got myself a 44 Magnum with extra mountain aroma. Some invertebrates have digestive tracts based on T.S. Eliot's poems with no tangible essence. How soft can you get?
We're just talking about basic television programs.
Well, one of the effects of television is to remove people's private identity. They become corporate, peer group people just by watching it.
With Shakalaka with the U2 ZooTV Tour, co-public enemy front with the B.A.D. Cold Dynamite, rocking nonstop with the sequence on Bono's face. Yo!
Will you show me? Show me how to do it! Oh!
talk to you on ZooTV. He seems to get closer and closer every night.
He touched me tonight.
Where did he touch you?
Well, right here. Kind
of, did he leave that mark?
No, he's going to grab my jewel one night. Young...
I had to do it, you see. I couldn't. Groupie or anything like that, but I had to breathe the same air as him. I had to move in his space. I don't know. I looked around. Looked around the room. My heart was beating so fast. I moved over to his bed.
Advertising is heading is quite simply into a world where the ad will become a substitute for the product, and all the satisfactions will be derived informationally from the ad, and the product will be merely a number in some file somewhere.
ZooTV, this thing, what is it?
There are many, many levels to ZooTV.
This is the lowest.
This is...
When you're 16, you think you can take on the world. And sometimes you're right.
I think there's a lot of people a bit puzzled, to be honest, about what we're up to, what we're trying to do.
I think ZooTV, for me, started during the Gulf War, you know, sitting at home, watching this war on TV and seeing, you know, through the eyes of CNN, you know, hundreds of thousands of people's lives exploded. And then being able to just change the channel and watch a sneaker ad. And I did, you know, and I, like everybody else, I channel hopped through the Gulf War.
You know, a lot of politicians were actually looking at CNN and keeping up to date based on what they could see going on the television.
Yeah.
Which means that, you know, the person who controls CNN, Ted Turner, is probably one of the most influential people in the world.
What do you think the message is in that?
Watch more TV.
Watch more TV.
I love this satellite thing. I love what you do, beaming across borders. That's what U2 is about.
The
kids. We might even borrow your satellite to do it.
I was going to say.
Why do you think I'm being nice to you?
We're into taking from whatever source we can, you know.
We don't care where we get it from. MTV, Disneyland.
We'll rip anyone off. CNN.
The elections, pornography, TV evangelism. We're just drawing on what's out there.
Does this reflect American culture? Adam, do you look at this and say, well, this show is more American culture than a typical British band tour?
I don't know if it's more American culture. I think it's more interesting that music has, I suppose, since the early days of MTV, it has taken on an audiovisual context that I think is here to stay. And I suppose with stadium concerts anyway, you had a lot of video reinforcement, but it was used in a very boring way. So I think it's just the next stage of the development of rock and roll and you know, the road that it's leading us down.
We know what we're doing. That is far out. How do you scream 20 floors down and be heard?
Rock and roll doggy.
That is the loudest voice I think I've ever heard.
Americus.
Surely there's more to it than that.
Don't call me Shirley.
Welcome to ZooTV.
This Christmas, I will be watching two young men. Now, that last bit wasn't very rude. But the fact that you expected it to be, and I disappointed you, turned me on.
Just one of many HMV presents for Christmas.
Remagel has exploded the idea that an effective indigestion tablet should leave a chalky, gritty taste behind. Remagel brings you fast, effective relief, but in a soft, chewy tablet. Now there's new Fresh Mint Remagel, just as effective, just as soft and chewy. Remagel, effective indigestion relief that's chewy. Not chalky.
That Gladys Oathorpe, she never buys her own.
Boddingtons, the cream of Manchester.
This is a Christmas appeal from the NSPCC to ask if you can make a donation now to help save a child's life. Every child dreams about what they'd like for Christmas.
I want a mountain bike with 10 gears.
I want a video game like my friend.
I want a doll turns into a princess.
I just don't want to be punched anymore.
This Christmas, there will be children whose only wish would be for the pain to go away. Children like Jane, beaten so badly her ribs were broken. Or Suzette, who survived winter with little heat, light, or food. Or little Stephen, whose arm was brutally broken just because he cried. It's children like these the NSPCC will do all it can to protect, but we need your help to do it. Will you give an abused child a gift of £15 this Christmas? Your £15 will help pay for the vital visit from a child protection officer. Your £15 will help keep our child protection helpline open for anyone to call who suspects a child is in danger. And your £15 means we can counsel more children to help put their nightmares behind them. So this Christmas, please imagine there's an extra child to buy a gift for and call 0800 28 20 28 now. That's 0800 28 20 28. We're waiting for your call. Thank you.
Good evening, I'm Rona Elliott here live in Dublin, Ireland, where within the hour you will be seeing U2 live. Follow me and you can see what is expected to be the most significant and exciting TV event since the Gulf War. Now, ZooTV is being broadcast right now live to 32 countries around the world, and there are commentators and translators in this room speaking in many languages. As you can see, they're here, Italian, Scandinavia, Holland and Germany. Let's listen. Okay, now the band have been on the road since last March, and they have just come home here to Dublin this weekend. Ireland's just had an election. They've just had a big hero's welcome. They've offered to be, Bono has offered to be the prime minister. So far, none of the politicians have responded. So in the spirit of homecoming in this live ZooTV broadcast, we'll be back later. Let's go first to Rex Fox at ZooTV.
Thank you, Rona. Amid rumors of stubborn stains, our fresh fruit contestants cut a third of the workforce today, leaving voters in no doubt it's the extra month on the tree gives your dog prolonged active life. No other cold remedy stops pain faster in the remote townships with improved cornering stability and the sheer luxury of better prostate health with a delicious low-fat lasagna. These are my son's shorts, two endangered species keeping up with the latest dance trends, taste buds tingling with emergency relief efforts in the wake of previously unseen footage of Elvis. Here's David Saltz.
Thanks, Rex. We're back here on top ZooTV outside broadcast, one of the highest points of the arena. We're watching the band as they rip into Until the End of the World, the title song for the Defenders movie.
Alcohol just passing time. Last time we met was a low-lit room. We was close together as bride and groom. We ate the food, we drank the wine. Everybody having a good time. To me, I'm still talking about the end of the world. The world.
Come on!
nature itself would be destroyed.
Governor Clinton. Governor Clinton doesn't think foreign policy is important, but anyway, he's trying to catch up. You may have seen this in the news. He was in Hollywood seeking foreign policy advice from the rock group, U2. Now, understand I have nothing against U2. You may not know this, but they try to call me at the White House every night during the concert. But the next time we face a foreign policy crisis, I will work with John Major and Boris Yeltsin, and Bill Clinton can consult Boy George. I'll stay with the experts.
And we're back here in New York live with all of the fellows in U2 here on the Global Satellite Network. We're going to go to the phones again. And our next caller is named Bill. He's from Little Rock, Arkansas. Bill, what's your last name? Bill?
Clinton.
Bill Clinton.
Yeah, I'm doing a big job interview in America.
This is Bono here. How do you want us to call you? Do you want to call us, should we call you Governor or Bill?
No, you call me Bill.
All right. And you can call me Betty.
I smoked pot in college, but I didn't inhale.
You're the last to hear the warning. You've been trying to throw your arms round the world. Been falling off the sidewalk. Your lips move, but you can't talk. Trying to throw your arms round the world. Gonna run to you, run to you, run to you. He was trying to throw his arms around a girl. Took an open top beater through the eye of a needle. I was trying to throw my arms around the world. Run to you.
When did you know you were going up on stage?
When it came with the bottle of champagne, I knew it.
Yeah! Who are you?
I can't move!
Who's a better dancer, Bono or John Travolta?
Definitely John Travolta.
You know, last time we saw you, you were a normal guy. You know, you wore normal clothes and stuff. Now you got the suits, you got the fly boots, you got the, the fly goggles. I think that's a dye job on your hair. What's going on?
You didn't like me when I was me, so I found somebody new.
You're not hiding something behind those shades.
And you love him. Old Blue Eyes is back.
Because
I have a spiritual sense of belonging. I used to make love under the red sunset. She would make all the promises I was soon to forget. She was pale as a lace of a wedding gown. I lived still standing before. Ran to children.
Malibu. The sun always shines when it pours.
When you get acid indigestion or heartburn, Rennie works fast. In fact, more people in Britain take Rennie than any other indigestion remedy. Fast, effective Rennie for on-the-spot relief.
Have you ever tried keeping a Terry's chocolate orange to yourself. There's always someone who has to interfere. Hardly surprising, when you think all that irresistible chocolate gets its unique orangey taste from only the finest oranges. And each delicious individual segment can only ever be released with a gentle tap. Terry's chocolate orange. Just try keeping one to yourself.
Mmm, what's that fragrance you're wearing?
Exclamation! Make a statement without saying a word.
Call 0891 80 8080. 1 plus 1 gets you together.
I'm a secret lemonade drinker.
Always, always.
I'm trying to keep it up, but it's one of those nights.
Always,
always, always lemonade. I'm a secret lemonade drinker.
As if by magic, the shopkeeper appeared. It's time to go home now, he said. On Festive Road, all the children were drinking our White's lemonade. Mr. Ben reached into his pocket. Why, he said, it's just what I need to help me remember. Our White's is made with real lemons.
And welcome back. Now, as you can see, I am surrounded by members of the International Press Corps here in the press room. There are about 150 people in all. And the first person I'm going to talk to is Martina, who is here from Germany. Martina, tell us your name and the paper that you work for.
I'm Martina Wimmer from Music Express Germany.
So what do you think of this big U2 event? Are you a U2 fan?
Not really. Well, I like the event anyway. It's kind of okay. I mean, I like the show up to now.
And what do you think about the TV show so far?
I liked it very much.
Can you give us an idea of what you're going to be writing about for your paper?
Just a small thing, maybe. Like, about the whole event, about the TV show. But I'm not quite sure how many people in Germany could watch it or how many people knew about it in Germany.
So you're happy you're here on the ZooTV tour?
Yes.
Okay, good. And our next guest is James Brown, who's from what paper in London?
I work for the Sunday Times Colour Supplement in London.
And what do you think of U2?
I think U2 are fabulous, you know? I think it's fantastic, the way they've reinvented themselves. And I also think it's very, very nice of Bono to step down from his job as Pope to take over the Prime Minister of the country.
Yes, and he offered to be the Prime Minister. No politicians have responded so far. And can you give us a preview of what you're going to write for your paper?
No.
No? Okay, well, we're moving right along to Francine Cunningham. Yes. She is a local girl. What paper are you from?
The Sunday Business Post.
And now, obviously, the boys have come home. And what's that like for you, being a Dubliner?
It doesn't really affect me personally. I think the entire program is completely self-serving.
Tell me a little more about that.
I think it's an extended promo for you two. I'd like to see them being asked some critical questions for a change.
If you could, if they were standing here right now, what would you ask them?
Well, I think it's entirely self-conscious. When Bono's playing a party or a rock star, he's still being a rock star.
Okay, so Bono, if you are listening to this and you see it later, this is something that you can listen to from Francine. Okay, good. And now, back to the show.
Harry, can you look at this whole thing that's going on stage and say, well, that's my little bit?
Sorry?
Let me rephrase that.
Which particular little bit?
Can you look at this whole thing that's going on stage and say, well, part of this is my creation, part of this was my idea?
Definitely not.
So they cut you out cold.
Absolutely.
What you're saying.
Yeah, I'm doing it for the money.
We've stumbled onto a sad story here. Do you think that the audience is getting something out of this? Do you think that they're seeing something new? Do you think it's stimulating their imagination?
Yeah, they're coming to a rock and roll gig and watching television. I think that, what more can you ask for?
It's a Lou Reed song. Satellite's gone.
gone way up to Mars. Soon it'll be filled with park and cars. I watched it for a little while. I love to watch things on TV.
And if almost by seance, the poet of New York appears on the giant video screens, high above Bono, in the place where he belongs, always looking over your shoulder.
Lou Reed, I've been told that you've been born life from the moon, with Harry Long and John. Monday and Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday, Harry, Mark, and John. The satellite's gone way up to the sky. Things like the drag me out of I love to watch things on ZooTV.
After this. Yeah. Why Berlin? I can't really remember back that far. The studio is really cheap.
There were no bad vibes there when we were there, other than, you know, edge of smelly feet or whatever.
I'm learning to lie. It's no secret. Obviously, Berlin was exciting because the whole reunification thing was happening. You know, there was a lot of change happening in Europe. I wouldn't say we went there for any political reasons. It just seemed like a place to be before it all changed.
Going into this record, we knew that certain things we'd done, we didn't want to do again. Certain kinds of songs we didn't want to write again. And the whole process in Berlin and in Dublin was finding out exactly where we did want to go.
And halfway through it, when we were making the record, we thought, you know, is this all going wrong? Have we got this terribly wrong? And we just went with it because we, you know, the you don't have a choice when you're in the middle of a record. You know, you're always going to doubt yourself.
Octoon, baby.
Octoon, baby.
Oh, I can't even say the bloody word. Octoon, baby.
Octoon, baby.
It never officially had another name. There was a brief moment when it might have been called Adam. But that depended on the photography. There might have been a much bigger fifth member on the sleeve.
Octoon, baby.
It's a calm. It's a calm. It's just a way of putting people off from the fact that it's a heavy mother. It's probably our most serious record, and yet it's the least serious title. And it just fooled everyone. They all thought we were in, you know, we lightened up, which is totally untrue. We're a miserable bastard.
Just did with the
nice little bird.
We're in the Gulf, in Iraqi territory. I'm commanding a tank. We're about to engage with the enemy. We've got a couple of Scud launchers to destroy and about half a dozen. Right now we're approaching an Iraqi tank, and this is the view from the tank. We've got radar to the right, we've got fuel gauge, we've got display of weaponry. We've got... This is the main one. It's incredible how it brings out a whole other part of your personality you just weren't aware of. You just want to kill as many of the enemy as you can in as short a space of time. You get completely detached from the concept of somebody being killed. It's just like, it is a game. But in a weird way, it's so sinister. I think there is a blur between what's real now and what's make-believe or what's synthetic reality. And I don't know what you can do about that, you know? That's where we're at. This feels very real. Some of the pilots coming back from their operations talking about the difference between their simulators and the real thing, and they were really excited about the fact that it looked real, which I thought was kind of a weird thing to say, as if it would in some ways be just another version of simulated reality. There's one more tank. Once he's knocked out, we move on to level two. There he is. We're closing in now. Yes. Mission complete. You always remember your first kill.
Yeah.
Homeless man in a major U.S. city was accosted by a group of aggressive young males. They stripped him, spray-painted the word scum onto his back, threw him into a garbage dumpster, set it on fire, and pounded the sides while he burned to death.
She's with her eyes painted red, under blue.
where the streets have no name. I'm Rona Elliott here live in Dublin with a ZooTV live broadcast. Just a few statistics. You may or may not know, U2 started their tour in March, the first leg of their two-year tour. So far in America, they've played to 3 million people. Achtung Baby, their current album, has sold 10 million copies. They've sold a whopping 600,000 t-shirts, and they will pick up the second leg of their tour in May 93. And they will be joining us here live in the studio in just a few minutes from now. And we'll be right back after these messages.
One of the first times I went to Vegas, to Las Vegas, went to see Frank Sinatra play. It was after the Sugar Ray Leonard Marvin Hagler fight. And we got in free to a $25,000 a table do in the Golden Nugget with Frank Sinatra singing. And he introduced us to the crowd. He said, this is a band from Ireland and they're number one this week in America. And they put on the spotlight and we stood up and we did the wave thing. Frank looked down and he said, my, he said, you didn't spend a dime on your clothes. Well, Frank, times have changed. I mean, rock and roll is ridiculous. It's funny. I mean, four jerks and the police escort. I feel we're still saying the same things, just using different language, different symbols. Hello? bigger limos. All the things I despised about rock and roll, I've now surrounded myself with. And I'm really enjoying it. I want to expose the lies, and sometimes by living them, you know, you can do that and take people on a trip and show them from the inside what it is, what stardom is, what to be a rock and roll star is. The hardest thing is to make it look spontaneous. Rock and roll is about mystery and mischief. And we're having a lot of fun with our public image, I suppose. We're playing with it. It's a mask. I'm not a hero. I'm a rock and roller. I'm spoiled rotten. I'm paid too much for what I do. Stardom is bullshit. It makes no sense to put people like me in the position that we are. We serve the music. The musician is not as interesting as the music. You know what I mean? It's like you people, you need heroes. You know, people want to, the media want to create heroes, but if I agreed to the job, you'd kill me. So, I'm backing out. We'll be right back.
irresistible new hat can help you save on your next bonnet. Airline tickets can get you first-class seats. And the occasional steak can lead to a tasty grill. Because Britain's most popular car manufacturer and Britain's biggest credit card have got together to create the Ford Barclay Card. It gives you all the advantages of a Barclay Card with the chance to save towards a new Ford every time you use it. You can save up to £600 a year with a maximum of £1,800 in 3 years. If you're already a Barclay Card holder, then from January, your existing profile points can count for up to £600 of that £1,800 saving. Call 0800 111 222 now. Ford and Barclay Card, making a Ford more affordable.
Max Factor International creates a new chapter in eyeshadow. High definition duos. A color lock base keeps color on for longer. For eyes they'll read up on.
Impact.
High definition duos, the longer lasting eyeshadow. New and only from Max Factor International.
I've been thinking, Jack. You know, the bloke's place isn't just at the pub enjoying a beer with his mates.
No?
Nah. You should go out into the world and find a good woman. Decent, strong woman who he can stand beside. Shoulder to shoulder. Tilling the land. Sharing the trials and tribulations that life throws at them as two equal human beings. Regardless of pubs and other distractions.
Colin McLeod?
Yep.
Worst case of sunstroke I've ever seen.
I'm Dave.
And I'm Emma.
And we're going to show you how to make a great nighttime snack. Get a bag of Kettle School Blades.
And some meal.
Find a clean bowl. And pour in the delicious flakes of corn.
Pour the milk over the Kellogg's cornflakes.
What you need.
Yummy! Especially right now.
Kellogg's cornflakes.
So delicious.
So simple.
So why wait till breakfast?
And welcome back. I'm Rona Elliott, and we are live from Dublin, Ireland with ZooTV. And one of the things we're going to be doing tonight as the live broadcast goes out to 32 countries is meeting one of Ireland's premier broadcasters. And his name is Pat Kenny. He hosts a TV show here in Dublin once a week. He's a very formidable gentleman. And now we're going to Pat Kenny in the studio.
That's exactly what Bono said when he arrived back from Mexico on Friday. I want to be Taoiseach. Now, you know that you two have been involved in a tour all across the United States, and indoors and outdoors, massive crowds with their ZooTV extravaganza. They're back in town, as I said. They're also with us tonight in this studio, and I don't know whether success has gone to their heads or not, but boy, have they changed. With a track from Achtung Baby, will you welcome, please, U2.
Going on here. We're going to try to sort out what's going on. There seems to be a
disaster here. What's happening?
Well, I don't know, sir. We're trying to sort out what's going.
People have flown 4 hours to come here.
Maybe we can sort. Excuse me. Just
works.
Excuse me. We're on live TV here. Yeah, you know.
I know. Try to.
I know we're on live TV, and of course we're going to try to sort out what's going on for you. Excuse me, sir. We're on live TV, and we're going to try to sort out what's going on. Now we're going to go to David Sauls. David, can you hear me? David Sauls, can you clear up what's going on? David, take it away. David,
don't go to me. I don't have anything. I have color bars. Don't. I can't. Don't.
Guys, what am I supposed to do? This thing doesn't work. I don't know. I don't know if it's the monitor. Yeah, it's the car. I don't know what's wrong with it. I don't know what... We have the only camera. To the studio, I don't know where it is. We're going to the studio. We gotta go right now. We're supposed to get to the studio. Everything's gone down. They have a satellite problem. We were supposed to go to the Bill Kenny show. I don't know where it is. I've gotta try to find it. We gotta go down there now, though. I don't know, who knows? Well, where's the Pat Kenny show? Sir, where's the Pat Kenny show? Okay, we're supposed to go into the Pat Kenny show right now. I solved the problem with the satellite. Let's go in. All right, here we are. The Pat Kenny show. If you guys can get the shot of the band. I don't know. What's going on here? I don't know. This is... Hey, wait a minute. That's not Bono Swagger. Who are these guys? Put it down. What's going on here? Are you Pat Kenny?
That's me, yeah.
Well, what's going on here? This is a U2. Is this a television rating
stunt
or something?
I know these guys.
There's the real band.
This is my studio.
There's the real band.
This is my studio.
Can we get a word?
Hey, this
can we get a word with you?
Hey.
Yeah, but we need to get an interview for ZooTV.
Come on, I don't care who you are.
Bono, can we get an interview with you for ZooTV?
Out of this studio. Where are you? This is their hometown. It's my hometown.
Adam.
Please,
Adam, Bono, can we just talk to you for ZooTV just for a moment?
Come on, there might be
Edge. Just a word. Anything.
I
don't know what's going on here, but it's totally ridiculous. We had a band here. It was a fake U2.
Yes,
we come out here to interview a band. That's I fly all the way from America.
Look, you're wearing this thing. You know what ZooTV is. We did a little ZooTV tonight, and you don't like it, okay?
No, I don't like it when I fly to America, fly economy, stay in a bad hotel here in Dublin, and then come on, and it's a bad Irish joke.
Okay.
We have better gags in America.
Okay, you've better guys. I've got my guests to talk to, okay? Goodbye. Welcome. It's great to have you back, fellas.
Thank you.
Will you explain to everybody who doesn't know what's ZooTV?
Planning permission submitted for one of the country's leading transvestites faces a real risk of implosion for a full Martian year playing Squeeze the Buttocks in a cold and hostile place, a stunning musical tribute to sales of cigarette machines in Russia. The delicate fragrance of 4.3% growth is worrying speculators with high-orbit gamma-ray pepperoni and cheese before sex sells complete devastation of the Amazon rainforest. Philadelphia, here I come. This has been Bob Evans for ZooTV News in Miami.
I'd just like to say that I still believe in moral absolutes based upon an eternal transcendent being who is the creator of all things, and I'm not talking about Elvis.
I'm on the streets. I'm on.
for all of this to be yours. I know, because I own it.
Five lane freeways.
You've heard of faith. I'll tell you about lift.
Free fall information.
We can take you over the world of the journey. Shall we go there together?
It'll lock in.
Ladies and gentlemen, will we go there together?
Laser guided missiles.
Will we travel by limousine together? Shall we open a bottle of champagne together?
She's my protection.
Have I got money to give away?
She is the promise on the year of election. Oh, sister, can let you go like a preacher stealing heart and a traveling show for love of money.
Let's call George one last time. What do you say? That's 1-202-456-1414. Okay. Hello, is that the White House?
Yes.
Hi, could I speak to President George Bush, please?
He's not available, sir.
George isn't available, but it's our last night. Hello? Could I leave a message for George?
No message to be taken this time, and
Hello? Could I leave a message for George?
Need to call back on Monday.
I was just gonna say I wouldn't be bothering him from now on, I'm gonna be bothering Bill Clinton now.